Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome to English class for 10th grade. Well, everybody, today we still study about recount text, especially about the biographical recount text. And everyone knows the picture of this screen, yeah? He is the Indonesian expert and very smart person. Well, students, today, yeah, we're going to talk about this person, especially on a text. Jadi, kita akan belajar tentang recount text mengenai biografi Bapak B.J. Habibie almarhum. Okay, next. You can look at the first paragraph. In the first paragraph, you can see some underlined sentence and the highlight words of vocabulary. Jadi di sini sudah saya tuliskan, saya sudah garis bawahi kata-kata yang menjadi poin-poin dari paragraf ini. Dan kata-kata yang menjadi sorotan atau highlight di paragraf ini saya akan bacakan. Okay. B.J. Habibie, Baharuddin Yusuf Habibie, known as B.J. Habibie, was born on 25th June 1936. He was the third president of the Republic of Indonesia, 1998-1999. Habibie was born in Parepare, South Sulawesi Province, to Alwi Abdul Jalil Habibie and R.A. Tuti Marini Puspowardoyo. His father was an agriculturist from Gorontalo of Bugis descent, and his mother was a Javanese noblewoman from Yogyakarta. His parents met while studying in Bogor. When he was 14 years old, Habibie's father died. Okay, jadi ada 3 poin di paragraf pertama. Ya, saya hanya akan menunjukkan poin-poinnya. You can look at in the explanation below. Ya, okay. Yang pertama, when and where Habibie was born. Ya, petunjuk di mana dan kapan Bapak B.J. Habibie dilahirkan. Yang kedua, ya, dan maaf, itu ada di kalimat yang saya garis bawahi pertama. Nah, kemudian Habibie's parents and they met, ya, orang tua Habibie, di mana mereka bertemu. Kemudian the last one, Habibie's father died, ya, tentang meninggalnya orang tua atau ayahnya Bapak B.J. Habibie. Nah, itulah poin-poin yang di garis bawahi. Dan sekarang kita lihat highlight vocabulary. Ada agriculturist, itu artinya petani. Kemudian descent. Descent itu adalah keturunan, ya. Okay, next paragraph. Following his father's death, Habibie continued his studies in Jakarta and then in 1955 moved to Germany. In 1960, Habibie received a degree in engineering in Germany, giving him the title Diplom Ingenieur. He remained in Germany as a research assistant under Hans Ebner at the Leverstuhl und Institut für Lichtbau, RWTH, Essen, to conduct research for his doctoral degree. Ya. Okay, sekarang Anda lihat yang di poin-poinnya dari paragraf 2. Yang pertama adalah Habibie's undergraduate study. Jadi pendidikan Habibie itu lulusan mana? Yang kedua, Habibie's doctorate study. Ya, pendidikan di mana B.J. Habibie mendapatkan gelar doctoral degree-nya. Research assistant itu artinya asisten penelitinya di sebuah perguruan tinggi namanya Hans Ebner at the Leicester Old Institute for Lichbau, ya, RWTH Essen itu, dan itu juga dalam rangka untuk mendapatkan gelar doktornya. Can I look at the third paragraph? In 1962, Habibie returned to Indonesia for 3 months on sick leave. During this time, he was reacquainted with Hasri Ainun, the daughter of R. Muhammad Besari. The two married on 12 May 1962. Returning to Germany shortly afterwards, Habibie and his wife settled in Assen for a short period before moving to Oberforsbach. In May 1963, they had their first son, Ilham Akbar Habibie, and later another son, Tarek Kemal Habibie. Ada 5 poin yang ada di paragraf ketiga. Ya, yang pertama, ya, yang paling atas itu adalah sick leave. Habibie sick leave itu artinya cuti sakit, ya. Yang kedua, Habibie met Ainun. Di mana Habibie bertemu dengan Ainun. Yang ketiga, Habibie got married with Ainun. Menikahlah dia dengan Ainun. Yang keempat, Habibie returned to Germany with Ainun, ya. Jadi setelah menikah, dia kembali ke Jerman dengan Ainun. And the last one, they had a new baby boy, dan mereka mempunyai anak, ya. And I look at the vocabulary highlight, ya. Ada sick leave, tadi sudah dibahas, itu cuti sakit. Kemudian reacquainted, itu ditemukan atau dikenalkan. And then settle itu adalah tinggal. Now look at the next paragraph. When Habibie's minimum wage salary forced him into part-time job, he found employment with the automotive Mark Talbot, where he became an advisor. Habibie worked on 2 projects which received funding from Deutsche Bundesbahn. Due to his work with Marcos, the head of train construction offered his position to Habibie upon his retirement 3 years later, but Habibie refused. The first point yang pertama, Habibie's part-time work with Talbot. Ya, jadi di sana dia menemukan pekerjaan otomotif yang bermerek Talbot. Jadi Mark itu artinya merek. Kemudian Habibie refused an offer from the head of train construction. Habibie refused itu artinya menolak. Menolak apa di sini? Tawaran bekerja di perusahaan kereta api. Nah, itu 2 poinnya. And I look at the highlight vocabulary, wage. Wage itu artinya upah. Jadi wage salary, ya, minimum wage salary. Jadi gaji upah minimal, ya, gaji upah minimalnya sedikit, kurang mungkinnya, maka itu memaksa Habibie untuk mendapatkan pekerjaan part-time work. Part-time work itu artinya paruh waktu, sampingan, ya. Kemudian ada employment itu pekerjaan. Dan Mark tadi sudah dibahas, itu artinya merek. And then the last one, retirement, itu artinya pensiun. Jadi dia ditawari oleh kepala dari perusahaan kereta api setelah dia nanti pensiun, tapi Habibie refused itu menolak. Next paragraph, Habibie did accept a position with Messerschmitt Polkow Blom in Hamburg. There, he developed theories on thermodynamics construction and aerodynamics, known as the Habibie's factor, Habibie theorem, and Habibie method, respectively. He worked for Messerschmitt on the development of the Airbus A300B aircraft. In 1974, he was promoted to vice president of the company. Yang pertama yang menjadi poin adalah having a position at the Messerschmitt Polkoplan in Hamburg. Jadi dia mendapatkan sebuah posisi di perusahaan tersebut. Nah, and then theories on thermodynamics. Jadi Habibie juga di situ dikenal sebagai pencipta sebuah teori. Ada tiga, ya, thermodynamic, construction, dan aerodynamics, ya, sebagai penghormatan, ya, atau prestasi dia, respectively, ya. And then the last one, to be promoted as vice president of the company. Dipromosikan menjadi wakil presiden dari perusahaan tersebut. Ya, oke, okay, next paragraph. In 1974, Soeharto requested Habibie to return to Indonesia as part of Soeharto's drive to develop the country. Habibie initially served as a special assistant to Ibnu Suwoto, CEO of State Oil Company Pertamina. 2 years later, in 1976, Habibie was made chief executive officer of the new state-owned enterprise, Industri Pesawat Terbang Nusantara, or IPTN. In 1978, he was appointed as Minister of Research and Technology. Habibie was elected Vice President in March 1998. On 21st May 1998, Soeharto publicly announced his resignation, and Habibie was immediately sworn in as president. Habibie's government stabilized the economy in the face of the Asian financial crisis and chaos of the last few months of Soeharto's presidency. Okay, well, ada 5 poin. Yang pertama, initial position, posisi yang dicapainya ya, secara resmi. Kemudian CEO of IPTN, and then Ministry of Research and Technology, ya, Menteri Riset dan Teknologi, Vice President, Wakil Presiden, dan Presiden, ya. Oke, okay, and then announce itu adalah mengumumkan secara publik. Nah, kemudian resignation. Resignation itu adalah pengunduran diri atau ya pengunduran diri. Kemudian sworn in itu disumpah. Dan yang last one is chaos. Chaos itu artinya kacau. Next paragraph. Since relinquishing the presidency, Habibie has spent more time in Germany than in Indonesia. However, he has also been active as a presidential advisor during Susilo Bambang Yudhoyono's presidency. In September 2006, he released a book called Detik-detik yang Menentukan, Jalan Panjang Indonesia Menuju Demokrasi. Decisive Moments, Indonesia's Long Road Toward Democracy. The book recalled the events of May 1998. Oke, okay? Last paragraph, paragraph terakhir adalah tentang kehidupan Habibie yang terakhir, di mana setelah dia melepaskan jabatan sebagai presiden, ya, Anda bisa baca di paragraf 7, di antaranya adalah dia lebih banyak tinggal di Jerman, dan juga walaupun di Jerman atau ketika kembali di Indonesia, dia juga menjadi penasehat presiden. Pada saat itu presidennya adalah Bapak Susilo Bambang Yudhoyono. Okay, that was the last paragraph. Thank you. I hope you can understand what I say. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.